But Rich, this time you do the talking.
Wait a minute, what's the big hurry? Let me make a few calls first in my office.
Ralph, that's Fonzie's office.
Not anymore.
Good, Fonz. Just stay cool.
I'm cool. I'm in control. I'm going to give you a minute to call an ambulance, and then it's best is next to kin. On second thought, I'm going to go in there. I'm going to stuff that kamikaze kid right down the drain.
No, wait, Fonz! Fonz, look, he's not himself.
Why would you do that? The drain ain't big enough for two of you.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, Fonz, but he's been hypnotized.
He's been hypnotized? Well, I sure do hope that it makes him immune to pain. Now, excuse me.
Fonz, please don't kill him. He's my best friend. He's my roommate.
I am in dire need of an explanation.
Rich, tell him.
Fonz, he doesn't know what he's doing because a professor with 4 degrees hypnotized him so he wouldn't be afraid of the tornado.
Right.
There's a tornado coming, Fonz, and he knew there was a tornado coming because the mice were dancing. Well, I guess he had to be there. But they were dancing.
Oh, there you are, Fonzarelli.
Ralph.
Now, before I take over your office, I want it spick and span. I mean, get those stupid combs out of there.
Hypnotism. It's hypnotism.
And another thing, Artie.
Artie.
That's right. That's right. You heard me, Artie. Artie,
just shut up.
All right. Look, calm is nice.
And another thing, Artie. You've really been bugging me lately. The way you ride that stupid motorcycle of yours. When are you gonna get some training wheels?
Mouse leaving. He's leaving.
Wait a minute. I didn't say anything about his crummy jacket yet.
No!
Get him unhypnotized, Fonz!